Welcome to Main Event Pong presents Books and Booze with Banshee and DZ.
That's me.
Today we're going to start with a book that kind of, this is I think the series that kind of got us collaborating on books, don't you think?
This is the book when she found out I read. She was like, what, black people read? When she found out some of the weird stuff I read, she introduced me to this. This was like the first one that got us really reading together on certain things. Mm-hmm. So this is not only the start of a franchise, it's the start of this reading.
This beautiful friendship
we got going on.
So we're all ready. We got our runes. Got our pair of batai runes. Got
Plain
our runes.
What that is.
Yes. So before we get into this, we are going to talk a little bit about what we're drinking. We're going to take a shot first. What are we shooting?
But this is a vodka with a little bit of mint. It's just to get this party started. Keep it fresh.
Ooh, it smells minty.
Yeah.
Woo! Woo! Whoa. I burned my nostrils.
So I think I cleared my sinuses.
Yes, make more. So this is what we're drinking. What we're drinking is called the Orange Creme Cocktail, and we Googled Mortal Instruments cocktails, and this is what Nuff found for us. So this is by a girl, Melissa Creates, I think her name is.
What's up, Melissa?
Shout out to Melissa Creates. And it is inspired by Magnus Bane. So this is, we decided that a lot of people had shared this, so we were gonna pay homage to Melissa's creation.
All right,
because
Melissa.
We like it when people make things, like when we made the white Rothkin. All right, let's taste this. You know what's fucking good? It's very sweet.
I think it's too sweet for me. It's Hangover City right here.
This is like, I'm gonna tell you this right now. You could order 7 of these and they will taste delicious and you will not feel like you're drunk at all and then you're passed out on the floor. All right, so let's get into Mortal Instruments City of Bones. Mortal Instruments is everywhere right now. You have Shadowhunters on ABC Freeform and you have the movie and then you have the series. So this was the first book in Cassandra Clare's career. So you started with this series, the Mortal Instruments, which is 6 books. Then you got the prequels, which is the Infernal Devices, which is 3, which is probably my favorite. I think the most perfect trilogy of all time.
We keep talking about that. Eventually we're going to get to
that. We're going to get to it, but I fucking love the Infernal Devices. So let's get into a little synopsis. At the beginning of the book. God.
Jesus. So bad.
It's so good. I fucking will drink this shit all day. So at the beginning, Mortal Instruments, you got Clary Frey, who is an aspiring artist being raised by her single mother. They don't have a lot of people close to them in their life. She's got basically one friend who is Simon Lewis, who is your stereotypical nerd. He is like the me. He's like the guy me.
And he's Jewish.
I don't know why that's important, but it is. And then you have their kind of family friend, pseudo uncle Luke Garraway. So these are the only people in Clary's world. So it's coming up on her birthday and she's turning 16. I mean, they make her, in everything that's come out, I feel like they've made her older than that. I mean, she's like applying for college in Shadowhunters, which I don't know if you've watched or not, but she's like applying for college. But in the books, Clary is turning 16. There's some stuff that goes down later where you're like, damn, she's only 16 and this shit's going
on. I know, right? Yeah.
I mean,
I don't want to think about it.
Yeah, exactly. Clary's turning 16 and her and Simon decide to go out for her birthday. So they go to a club, and while they are at a club, kind of like cute hot demon kind of catches Clary's eye. She kind of catches his eye. She pays attention to him in the club, and then he's distracted and goes off with some other people. Well, Clary, being curious Clary, follows them into a storeroom where basically it's 3 Shadowhunters, Jace Herondale and Alec and Isabel Lightwood, are tracking this guy and they basically kill him, and Clary tries to defend him and is like, you can't kill that guy, what are you doing, blah blah blah, you know, but can't really say anything because everybody's gonna think she's crazy.
Yeah.
So kind of bit of banter back and forth between her and Jace where he calls her a little girl.
That's what starts.
They're a little bit confused as to why Clary can see them, because you have to be a Shadowhunter or like have the sight or a downworlder. And when we say downworlder in the Mortal Instruments world, we're talking about people that are kind of half demon. Yeah, so if you're a demon, you're a demon. If you're a Shadowhunter, you're a part angel. And then you have kind of half demons in the middle.
No, those are warlocks.
So you got your warlocks, you got your fairies.
Mm-hmm. They're the fae, they're in it too.
You got your
werewolves,
and you got your vampires. That's basically it. I mean, you got a bunch of different kind of demons, like you got your Shax demons, your Elodie demons, and stuff like that. So unless you're one of those, or you have the sight, which is just a human that can see the shadow world, which is most humans can't see all of those things. They can't see magic, they can't see, you know, runes on Shadowhunters, if a Shadowhunter's using an invisibility rune, because their runes have power, just so you know. So that's where they get their power from, is runes and their angelic blood. But most mortals can't see that unless they have the sight, which means that somewhere back in their line there was probably something a little magical in there. I got the sight too.
Okay, good. It's, yeah. It's a burden. You
know, it is a burden. Yeah. Anyway. So they're wondering why she can see them, because she's not really displaying any downworlder abilities. And I feel like Shadowhunters have like a sixth downworlder sense.
Well, yeah, because they're...
They always know.
They're still in the supernatural, mm-hmm. So they're almost in that same club themselves.
Mm-hmm. True. Yeah. She goes there, she comes home, she's freaking out. She's like, I just saw somebody kill something, whatever. Move the story plot along a little bit. Turns out that her... Basically, Clary's mother is, Jocelyn Frey, is kidnapped. Her house is trashed and she doesn't know what happened. She goes to basically try to find Luke to figure out what happened. They get attacked. Clary basically gets put unconscious and Jace puts an invisibility rune on her, right?
Some kind of fortitude rune. Yeah.
And that's when they find out that she does have Shadowhunter blood, because otherwise she would have died. So she would have died if he hadn't done that. When Clary finds that out, she slaps him because she's like, how did you know I would survive? And he's like, I didn't. And she's like, bam, slapped you, whatever. So.
The relationship is very, you know.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Interesting at first.
It's very interesting.
Where she's attracted but don't like him.
Is you time. Got that, like I said, remember in the last one where I was like, you got your Edward Collinses, your Jace Herondales, and your Force, where obviously Jace is a Jace, so he's got his little attitude, bad boy, you know, I'm not gonna be too romantic, but I'm sexy, and I know it, you know, and he's always saying shit like, I'm gorgeous, and whatever, like, he's fine as fuck, and he knows he's fine as fuck.
That everybody hates.
He's like, he looks all cherub-like with this golden curly hair, and he'd be looking like that douche from Rain. King Francis, but with the yellow eyes, he's all perfect and gorgeous.
He could probably do better.
He's all built, but like in a lean, like swimmer body kind of way, and he's got all his rune tattoos. I'm not gonna lie, I'd hit on him if I were single and I was in a club and he was there. I'd be like, hey Jake, I love you. She takes him to the Institute. The only people at the Institute are Jace, Clary, the Lightwoods, Isabel and Alec, and Hodge. Hodge being like the headmaster or the caretaker of the Institute. Hodge is agoraphobic. You think he's agoraphobic? So he thinks he can't leave. Maybe he can't. There's a spell on him where he can't leave. His punishment for being in the circle. The circle was kind of like a cult, or a faction, if you will, of Shadowhunters who wanted to eradicate all downworlders, mm-hmm. Led by Valentine Morgenstein.
Or Valentino. That's what you're about to say.
Yeah, Valentine Morgenstein. Hodge was in his little, like, band of misfits or whatever, band of rogue people or whatever. His punishment from the Clave for being in there is that he cannot leave the New York Institute. They give Clary a little rundown of what's going on. She's like, I need your guys' help to find my mom. They go to Madame Dorothea's. Madame Dorothea is a witch. Witches are not downworlders. They have the sight, like we were talking about. They are humans with the sight. She has tarot cards, and that's when Clary finds out that she has some kind of spell on her that is preventing her from remembering the shadow world. Mm-hmm. So, the Shadowhunters tell Clary, look, we're gonna go see this warlock Magnus Bane, because he's the only one who can maybe take this spell off.
Introduce Bane.
Mm-hmm. So we introduce Bane. or they go to the City of Bones first. One of the two. I don't know. Either way, they think that the Shadow Brothers of the City of Bones or Magnus Bane, one of them can reverse the spell. They go to Magnus Bane's party. A lot of downworlders there. He's a little attitude about Shadowhunters. Bane is a warlock. He's immortal. He's been alive for a long time. So he lived through... Shadow downworlders are kind of persecuted in the Mortal Instruments world. So, long story short, Shadowhunters have like a superiority complex with the downworlders. They think they're better than them. You know,
they hunt and kill them. But, you know.
Yeah, they've tried to kill them. Circle. That's what the circle was all about. And Bane has lived through the majority of that. So he, though he has had, you know, some friendships and alliances with Shadowhunters in the past, he did not trust the majority of them. He trusts like 1% of them, and he cannot stand 99% of them, because, to be honest, they're a little...
douchey.
Yeah, they are a little douchey.
They are like Jace.
They can be a little white people in like the 1600s. Like, they can be like that. You know what I'm saying? Like...
Yeah, they definitely have that superiority complex.
He's like, no, you guys cannot stay. Only the one with the gorgeous blue eyes can stay. No, he's like, you guys can all stay, but only because of the one with the gorgeous blue eyes, who is Alec, who is gay, but in the first book is terribly in the closet and also in love with Jace. A lot of relationship drama going on in Mortal Instruments.
But Bane is not in the closet. He is super... Well, he's
bisexual.
Yeah, he likes
He'll fuck
too.
Anything. Yeah, as long as they have blue eyes. He's like a... Yeah, he's a... I don't think he has a preference per se. He is very open in the sense of... I feel like he's evolved in the sense of he's been alive so long that he has learned to... He's tried everything once, and he has learned to judge the person based on their soul and not anything like on the outside. Not that he's not totally physical, because he would not do anybody ugly, now that I think about it. But I think that he... I think that when you're immortal, you probably just get bored of just one thing.
Possibility.
You know? I mean, he's relationships with men, women, downworlders, like, that are not in the same, you know, category of downworlder that he is. Like, he's got a lot of stuff going on in his life. You should read the Bane Chronicles. Bane's one of the best characters. So anyway, he basically tells Clary he can't, that her mom put her in this, you know, gave her this spell for a reason. She shouldn't be trying to get into this. Her mom wanted her to have a normal life separate from this. It's dangerous. This is why she's kidnapped. And that he can't reverse the spell. Yes. So while they are... Oh, you hated it so much.
I hate it.
You finished it.
No.
No.
That's not it. No, I don't want no more.
You know what though? The orange something or other? I didn't think it was going to be a lot of orange because it's just an orange. Mm. But it does totally taste like a creamsicle.
It's
with
whatever.
Blue carousel.
I think he needs ice.
So Bane tells him all that shit, and whilst at their party, Simon pretty much gets kidnapped by vampires, and they go back to the institute.
Well,
and
first he turns into a rat.
That's right. They turn into a rat, and then he gets kidnapped by vampires. So
Simon has a horrible...
God, it sucks to be fucking Simon in these books.
Yeah.
It sucks to be Clary too, but it sucks to be Simon.
No, that'll lead me to something later, because Simon, I think...
He is fucked up.
Simon has a hard knock life.
You know what though? Jace kind of gets a lot of shit.
Jace is nothing.
Let me argue this point before I move on, okay? This is a Shadowhunter thing. You know, they talk about in all of these books, all the spin-offs except for the prequels because he wasn't born yet, but they basically talk about Jace like he's the greatest fucking Shadowhunter that ever lived. Like, he is Jonathan Shadowhunter. Jonathan Shadowhunter was the first Shadowhunter. Mm-hmm. And they'll be like, even if you read this book over here, or like if you read Tales from the Shadowhunter Academies, the stigma about Jace is crazy. And he is very badass in this book. Jace's most badass book, though, I think is City of Ashes, which is book 2. Mm-hmm. That's when he like jumps really high. I mean, he's just pimped, starting fights with werewolves for nothing just because he's angsty. Like, he is badass in City of Ashes. But if we're talking about Jace being the most powerful Shadowhunter of all time, it's book 2. It's book 1 and book 2 where he's the most badass. Mm-hmm. Which leads me to kind of, he's reckless. It's kind of self-loathing. You know, his mother is, he believes his mother is dead, and he, His father is dead too, so he's been an orphan raised by the Lightwoods, but he has never felt, even though he feels like they're his family, you still kind of feel like the outsider, like the fourth, you know, they have three children. Like, how are you not going to feel like you're not really their child, you know, or whatever? And though I feel like he feels like their family, and later in the books he comes to terms with that and he realizes this is my family, there is some self-doubt in this book and the second book and even the third book about, you know, his feelings for the Lightwoods. I mean, he has kind of a conflict in the second book with Maurice Lightwood, who is the matriarch. So, but he basically goes against Alec, who's Alec's kind of in charge when his parents are gone. Alec is like, no, we can't do anything. We gotta run it by the Clave. He's very much kind of like Alec. I love Alec, but he's very much by the book. He's very much, let me follow
orders.
I gotta do the right thing. Let me do what they say. And part of me thinks that Alec is like that because he needs to maintain control over the little things in his life, because I think that he is so much in the closet that he wants to prove, he wants to put on this illusion of being the perfect Shadowhunter boy so that people don't find out his secret. And I think that internally, part of him wants to be like, I have these feelings about men, I'm gay, but it's not gonna affect the type of warrior that I am. I am still fucking badass, and Alec is badass. He does some badass shit later on in the books too.
He does.
Yeah, so he says no. So of course Jace is like, you tell me no, that's just gonna make me wanna do it more. So he takes Clary and busts into the Hotel Dumont, which is like the fucking vampire den of all vampire dens, to try to rescue Simon. So they rescue Simon, whatever, bring Simon back after crazy fight with all these, you know, get on their little vampire bike, take
Didn't
off.
Did werewolves show up too?
Yeah, werewolves.
It was a big old werewolf vampire showdown, wasn't it? I don't remember.
So they get back to the Institute, they get Simon, Clary's still there because she is trying to find out, you know, what's up with her parents. Jace takes her on a little midnight. They have like a atrium with like a magic garden with flowers that bloom at only midnight.
And at work, she gets all turned
on. Yeah. And he's like, we didn't celebrate your birthday, so let's go. I don't know. So let's go up and celebrate your birthday. They go up there. He gives her a witch light. They have like a little picnic of cheese and shit. And then they make out. And then she's walking him back to her room. And then Simon's like, what the fuck? Clary, I just got kidnapped from vampires for you. What the fuck? And Jace is like, oh, okay, I see. You're just gonna run off with him. Whatever. Love triangle ensues.
Which you should, but that's a whole nother argument.
Run, yeah. So Simon's pissed at her. Jace is pissed at her. While they're both pissed at her, she ignores both of them, goes to the study, and realizes, oh, fuck, I have this ability. I have this rune where I can pull fucking shit out of paper. So she realizes earlier when she was at Madame Dorothea's, fuck, I saw this mortal cup that they showed me. That's what we found, big part of the book I skipped. That's what Valentine, who kidnapped Jocelyn, is looking for. He is looking for the mad mortal cup. Mortal cup, you have to, if you drink from it, you become a shadow hunter. So he wants to create the circle who hates downworlders. So he needs a mortal cup to create more shadow hunters. It's been lost for forever because Jocelyn has been hiding it in Madame Dorothea's tarot card thing. Clary realizes it when she finds out she has that ability, and she grabs Jace and she's like, hey, shut up, whatever. I know you're pissed at me, but guess what? I know where this shit is. So they all go. They fight. They're about to die. Simon saves them because turns out dude is an archer. Turns out he's really good at archery. Him and Alec, they're the archers of the Mortal Instruments world. And then blah, blah, blah ensues. They find out where Jocelyn is. She's at Renwick's, which turns out there's only two portals in New York. You know, one is in Madame Dorothea's, the other's in Renwick's. They go. While they're there, Jace is there, finds out Jace is like, oh, guess what? I just learned that my dad is not dead. I thought Jonathan Wayland was dead. He's not. Turns out Valentine Morgenstein was masquerading as Valentine, and he is my dad, and now he's alive, and he has Jocelyn here. And it turns out, guess what, Clary? He's your dad, too. So you get a little fucking Luke Skywalker, Princess Leia
exactly
moment. Where
it.
You're like, oh, shit, they made out! And they have feelings for each other, but they're brother and sister! Cassandra Clare's a huge Star Wars fan. She can see it, because she put some shit in it with Simon, too. Remember that time when, like, Isabel Lightwood is like, big Star Glider! Do you remember that part?
No.
Oh my god, I love that part. It's one of my favorite parts. Some of the other things we didn't talk about, there's a little bit of flirtation going on between Isabel and Simon. He doesn't take it super seriously because he's in love with Clary.
And he's a nerd. He don't see it.
Yeah, exactly.
But she's not really forward either.
No. Isabel straight up is trying to molest Simon in the first. She kisses him, I think, doesn't she? Yes, she does, I think.
I don't remember.
But they're talking about how bad Isabel's cooking is. She's constantly trying to cook for Simon in the first book. But she's mostly just bored and knows that her parents will not like that she's hitting on a mundane.
Oh, yeah, she's
Isabel's always trying to find, like, some way to have some kind of conflict. Downworlders.
Her original impulse with Simon was to make her parents mad,
yep.
I think.
But I think so, too. And just because he's in the Institute, nobody else is, and she's bored. Like, she just wants to...
He's food at first.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
It's a plaything at first.
Exactly. If you were in the Shadowhunter world... Would you want to be a Shadowhunter, or would you want to be a Downworlder?
Shadowhunter.
I would want to be a Shadowhunter.
Yeah, for the superior. Right. I already act like I'm better than everybody. I'm already
better. Yeah, you do.
Either that or a werewolf, but I have a secret thing about werewolves.
So I love werewolves too. But then Bane is such a badass warlock,
he's dope.
Tessa Gray is a warlock, and I would want to be Tessa. So, but I mean, you learned some more shit about Tessa's background, but she's technically a warlock.
Yeah.
So I would love to be Tessa too. I don't know, I love the world. I'm so obsessed with it. Like I said, next Harry Potter, it's probably the series I'm the most obsessed with.
It's a very dope, supernatural world that she's created.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, there's, like, other ones, like True Blood. Everyone loves True Blood. Mm-hmm. Who doesn't? That's a pretty dope, supernatural world. This one's up there. Twilight's not. I'm sorry.
I feel like with this, they've created more of a... with the Clave is like the government of the Shadowhunters, and they give you a lot of different like folklore and a little like government aspects of the way different Downworlders, I mean like the fairies take, for example, you got the Seelie Queen, you got the Unseelie Queen, the King or whatever. I feel like Harry Potter, that she created a world within a world and she shows you how everything fits in.
She did a good job of it.
Mm-hmm. And what I like a little bit, what I like about especially the first book is in Harry Potter you only get Harry and he's so like doped out on whimsy, you know what I mean? But with Simon, I feel like he is like your mundane passport, like your mundane POV everything.
That's another reason why I like mm-hmm. him, which I was gonna, once we talk about our...
Yeah.
I was gonna get into
you want to do it? Let's do it right now. Who's your favorite character?
Favorite character, Simon.
He loves Simon. I love Simon too. But...
And through all this series, because Simon's path is a true human
mm-hmm.
path. That
Simon is
because
such
he's in
a
love,
human character.
Because he's in love, he follows Claire to the end of the world, still puts all his stuff on the line for her, ends up in this whole world mm-hmm. because of her, and then creates his own destiny afterwards. Like, I'm not going to spoil it for you.
My God, Simon's story is so good.
Yeah, his path is my favorite
path. It is just as good as Clary's. Clary can do some crazy shit, but some stuff that goes down with Simon is so good.
Simon's got a lot
God.
Of...
Some stuff that goes down with Jace is amazing too, but God, Simon's... They get biblical on you.
It's almost like this book is basically... Clary, but if I had to talk about the two main characters for this book, to me it's Simon and Clary.
Well,
because their relationship, his relationship, you care just as much about him as you do about Clary when the book's over. Favorite character?
It's so hard because there's so many good characters.
Favorite character for this book only, because I know
I'm
you.
I'm gonna say Alec. For this book only, I'm gonna say Alec. And I just think, I love the way that he's coming to terms with who he is. And how he is righteous. He thinks he's trying to do the right thing. There's a little bit of jealousy at play that he can see Jace having feelings for Clary. And he thinks he's in love with Jace. But really, it turns out, he's not in love with Jace. He's just in love with... He's gay.
No, he's in love with Jace.
I don't think he is.
He just gets over it.
No, I don't think he's in love with Jace. I think that he knows that Jace is not gay and that he can have feelings for a guy but not have to explore them because Jace is not gay and he's family.
That's true, but he's okay. Alec is in love with Jace.
I don't think he is.
He is in
love
with
him. That's what I'm saying. I think he's over it
and realizes that.
I mean, I think he recognizes Jace as fucking hot. Not as shit, because who wouldn't? But, like, not that Alec is not fine as fuck, because I love guys with blue eyes and dark hair, like Mag Nisbane. Mag Nisbane and I have the same fucking taste. Anyway, here's my favorite quote of the first book. How exhausting, Clary thought, to fight all your life and then be expected to continue that fight even when your life was over. I don't know. You know what I mean?
These tattoos, these runes itch.
So there are some authors who do this really well. Jennifer Armentrout does it really well. Jennifer Wheel does it really well. Edna Walters, my girl, Edna, I love you, does it really well. But when you mention a lot of pop culture in your books, I love that shit. Cassandra, I feel like, originated that. I feel like she was the first person who did that. Can you think of someone who really before that threw all their favorite shit into a book?
What do you mean, like, favorite?
Or you mean like, you know, current? Mention Star Wars, mention Harry Potter, mention, you know, like, Jennifer Armentrout mentioned Supernatural a lot.
Well, we're in the middle of Percy, and they mentioned Taylor Swift.
Dude, I know, right?
I thought that was weird.
Yeah. But you know what, Percy? I'm liking Percy, though. I'm not gonna lie. But anyway, but, like, yeah, I feel like she was the first person to really be like, hey, I'm a fangirl. I'm a serious writer, but the reason I wanted to write is because I am a fangirl. And I feel like that's me. That is me. And that's what I love about the way Cassandra writes. And I feel like Cassandra's almost like a, I don't know, there are things about, like she reminds me a little bit of like, in some way she reminds me a little bit of V.C. Andrews. She reminds me a little bit of, I don't know. She just, there's so many different things she does. But I, you know, there's some controversy saying that she stole some shit from What's-Her-Face from the Demon Hunter series. I've said this before. I think there's room for similar stories. I don't think that at all.
As long as you pay homage.
I don't even think, who cares? Like, I feel like, I mean, I read a book recently that's similar to something I had been writing for years, and I was like, fuck, that's kind of similar to something I was writing.
This right
here. But it wasn't intentional.
This right here, the fact that even though I haven't heard the story of, like, people who have angel blood,
yeah.
But the whole Hunter society, that's every single supernatural thing ever. That's everything.
That's everything.
I've done it. I got one I'm working on now.
Who did it first? Like, who did it first?
I don't know. That's
everything. Yeah, exactly. So why are you going to pay homage to anything? I'm just saying, like, I don't know. I feel like, take everything back to Dracula. You know what I mean? Bram Stoker's Dracula or whatever. Like, you got demon hunters in there.
There's
fucking Van
everything.
Helsing. Yeah.
Hunters.
You could say any demon hunter is based on Van Helsing, arguably. I don't know. Like I said, there's just something about this series that is so addicting.
It's unique. It's an interpretation to a story, even though there's so many different hunter stories and supernatural stories. Oh, good job. Hey, pop the top. There you go.
All right, let's rate it.
Well, we already know what we're going to rate.
I rate it a 5.
I rate it a 5. Okay, so this is the quickest rating ever.
Yep.
So I rate it a 5, too. I never even heard about the series. She told me about it. I got my little sister on it. She loved it. It's a good series.
He does hate Clary, though.
Clary's kind of selfish. I've always had a thing for the selfish heroine.
Selfless. He likes Triss from
Dark Ranger. No. I don't like the selfish heroine. But I like the selfless heroine. So yeah, I do like Trish. But other than Clary, I like every other character. I like Simon. I like Bane.
I love Bane, you guys.
Jace is kind of a douche. I like Alec. I like Isabel. Go ahead. I like Luke a lot. But go ahead.
Bane is so fucking funny. It's just anytime Bane says something, I don't have anything highlighted from this book, but I know I got shit highlighted from other books where Bane is just being funny as fuck. Mm-hmm. I just love Bane. I just love, and what's his face that plays him on? I prefer the guy who plays him on Shadowhunter. Shadowhunter is a TV show. It's the dude. It's the dancing dude from Glee, Harry something or other. And when they casted it, he was the one. Him and Simon were probably the ones I was most skeptical about, because Simon was the dude from Misfits, Robert Shanahan or whatever his name is. He was fucking good as Simon in the movie. I thought he was good. What do you think?
Did they cast the same Simon for
no,
the movie?
No, but he's like, he plays Simon exactly the same way. So he's good. I think he's really good. I'm not talking shit, but I was skeptical when I saw him. In the movie, I thought he was really good, right?
Simon should have been black, but that's what
I thought. Oh my god, stop it. But Maureen is black, Maya's black, Luke is black, and I love him in the show.
Well, he's the old
It's a man
guy.
You're a man because
Hello,
you're like,
yeah,
I'm old. On a horse.
Yeah, of course he's Luke, but he's Simon, so fine, to me, dude. Simon should have been black. But.
It's like this, they cut to Luke in the Shadowhunters show, and I'm like, okay, take your shirt off. Not that I didn't love Aiden Turner as Luke in the movie. I thought he did a really good job.
Not even a little bit.
You don't think he did a good job?
The movie was so bad, everybody. Except
no.
for homegirl from Game of Thrones. Other than that, everything was bad.
No, Lily Collins was good as Clary.
No.
Yes, she was. Okay, that's... Lily Collins, I think, is the better Clary. I'm Catherine McNamara is growing on me, but I fucking love Lily Collins. It's not her fault. She acted really well. Watch it again.
It's not her fault the movie's bad.
It's not her fault, no. And but I love her as Clary. I like Jimmy Campbell Bauer as Jace too, but God, Dominic, what's his face, is fucking sexy as fuck as Jace. And I like both Alex, but Matthew Daddario is so fucking fine. But Kevin Zegers is fine too. They're both good, but man, the show nailed the Lightwoods. You gotta watch the show. The show has nailed the Lightwoods.
I actually have not seen any episodes of the show yet.
Didn't you tell me one time in the movie that Isabel's just like, whatever?
She was whatever in the movie.
She's so good in the show.
She doesn't even exist in the movie.
Or whatever her name is, she is so fucking good in the show.
I will have to, I don't know why.
But I do think overall it's better. It's got... I mean, they've kind of crossed a lot of books. They've done some shit that... They've reached into book 4 in the first season. But right now, they're kind of at the end of book 2. Mm. All right, well, anything else you want to say about Mortal Instruments?
No, this is probably our longest episode.
Because we love it! We can talk about Mortal Instruments like all day, every day! Anyway, no. So thank you for joining us at Books and Booze, Banshee and D's. Hopefully Percy Jackson comes next time. Scott, we hope you feel better. We're going to be taking a little road trip later in the month. We may or may not film it. We'll be going to a premiere from my friend Sarah Elizabeth Santana, who is an amazing writer who wrote a book called The Awakened. If you haven't read it, you need to read it. The sequel, The Sanctuary, is coming out. I'm going to moderate her panel at her book release. And Dweez is going to come with me. And
Security. No?
No, he's my co-host, man. And that's it. Thanks for joining us. I had the most fun ever talking about one of my favorite series here.
Yeah, this book is this is in our blood.
It is. We love it.
Even though I haven't said much, I'm just drunk. Even though she's finished.
Shut the fuck up. I'm drunk too. No. Thank you. Bye. Oh, bye. Shit.